Hey guys, this is my first art-related video, believe it or not. This is also to the kids in my Japanese class, and the wonderful Mr. K is my YouTube channel. Yes, I make videos, and this is my shameless self-promo in school while also doing something I love for a school project. Yo! I don't really like taking the lazy route and standing in front of a PowerPoint reading off the board while everyone falls asleep. Anyway, on to the reason for this video, and not a two-page essay. Harajuku is basically like normal Japan. Honestly, there's nothing too different I found in the culture besides the fashion. I'm sorry, Mr. K, but I cannot just write two pages on fashion. I'm not that into style. I did, however, choose to paint a portrait of a Harajuku girl with her legs cut off because I love pretty gore. Art is what I love. It's my way of expression, just like how people in Harajuku dress certain ways to express themselves. Now onto the real information. Harajuku is a small area in Tokyo that is now considered one of the fashion hotspots in the world. Its youth culture and style is actually often compared to Louis Vuitton and Chanel. It's important to mention that there are many different styles on the streets of Harajuku, some of the most popular being Lolita, cosplay, Visual K, Gaiaru. I'm butchering these last two names, Gaiaru and Yamanba. Lolita is basically a style that embodies a modest Victorian era inspired look. Full-length cupcake dress with a petticoat, knee-high stockings, corsets, and headdresses. It actually kind of looks like this. Visual K, which actually has a more androgynous look than others, is very interesting to me. People sporting this trendy style, which was started by a Japanese pop music scene. Yeah. Usually don't look too feminine or masculine. That's what androgynous means. It involves garish costumes and flamboyant hair and makeup, and this is also what it looks like. Gyaru is a term that was transliterated from the English word, wow, gal, which I didn't know was a real word. Anyway, this style is taken as very childish and girly looking. There are also sub-styles of this style, so clothing varies for this trend based on those sub-styles. But the makeup is usually very bright and out there, and the hair is either bleached or dyed. Here's another photo. Yamanba is a term that literally originates from the Japanese phrase Yuba, whatever, which means mountain hag, and I don't think I've ever been so happy to learn anything like that. It's beautiful. Anyway, the looks for this trend is terrifying. Very dark, often brown, tan, radical, and clown-like makeup, neon and sometimes dreadlocked hair, etc., etc. Wow, etc. It takes the style Ganguro, I think, to a whole new level, and it's crazy. Here are some photos.